CNN offers proof of Moore's sexual abuse, viewers shocked by what's accidentally showing. With the left going absolutely nuts about the accusations against Roy Moore, it seems that CNN has decided to dive headfirst into taking the man down. Too bad for them, they recently decided to show some proof of Moore's sexual abuse, but it immediately blew up in their face as soon as shocked viewers saw what was accidentally showing. What we're seeing these days is an all-out assault on Roy Moore by the left after he began seeking a Senate seat, a Democrat hit job if you will. Of course, the Democrat Party is desperate to get blue politicians into Congress, and they seem to have a mindset of whatever it takes, even if it means ruining someone's reputation with false allegations. Sadly, it seems that morals and ethics go out the window when it comes to these senseless attempts to stop a member of the GOP from getting a seat, and liberals everywhere are proving just that. As Mad World News has previously reported, it's starting to look like Moore's accuser, Beverly Young Nelson, isn't exactly being honest. Not only does her body language suggest that she's acting, according to a body language expert, but the yearbook signature meant to prove that she and Moore were acquaintances appears to be forged, and now, even her own stepson is saying she's lying. Despite this reality, the fake news network CNN has most recently decided to share their own proof, but there's just one problem. As can be seen in CNN's recent post to Twitter, they shared an image of the signed yearbook that many believe is forged, saying it is proof that they knew each other. However, viewers were immediately left shocked to see what was accidentally showing, the fact that Moore's message was miraculously written in two different colors of ink. Of course, CNN wouldn't knowingly publish a photograph that blew up their entire narrative, but that's exactly what happened. In fact, others were quick to point out another little fact that's not in Nelson's favor, seeing how Moore reportedly signed the note with the letters DA following his name. Unfortunately for whoever thought this was a good idea to fake, he wasn't a DA until a few years later, meaning that he wouldn't have written that. Shockingly, it seems that the evidence is mounting against Mrs. Nelson, and things aren't looking good. It's bad enough when your own family calls you out for being a liar, but the fact that your own evidence proves that you're making things up takes the situation to an entirely different level. If one thing has been made clear here, it's that the left doesn't want Moore in office. We all know that they're desperate for power right now, seeing how they have none, but this is just ridiculous. There is absolutely no reason to tarnish a man's name and kill his career simply to keep the American people from electing the man they want to represent them in office. Like always, Democrats can't win fairly, so they're taking to disgusting and dirty means to get what they want. In the end, this is going to blow up in their face. And that's already turning out to be the case. With Moore's approval ratings the same now as before the accusations surfaced, it's looking like he may be elected despite the left's best attempt at otherwise, and what a kick in the teeth that has to be for them.